Hello there. Welcome to this Turnitin Originality video presentation for instructors. I am Kimberly Ann Soria, your facilitator for today. Turnitin Originality is integrated in Mapua University LMS Blackboard. There is no need to upload students one by one anymore. Grading and feedback of Turnitin assignments are made possible through Blackboard functionalities. It is upon the instructor's decision whether to have all of the assignments run through Turnitin or not. How to create assignments and run it through Turnitin in Blackboard? Simply go to the course you are handling, create a content, or for this example, I am going to include it in one of my activity in week one, online discussion one. Click Build Content and choose Turnitin. You will then be redirected to the Turnitin platform. For initial assignment creation, only the general settings are available. Input name of the assignment. For this example, I will name this trial one and then type in your instructions for the students. Identify the start and end date. And then create assignment. Once it is done, let us close this tab and go back to the course. As you can see, the assignment is not yet reflected in this content. Simply click refresh and go back to the content area where we have created the assignment. Now that it is here, just like how you have been doing with your assignment, it is important for instructors to edit the assignment or task. For this example, I'll click on Edit and input the points possible for this assignment. Identify the due date as identified in the Turnitin platform and select the date and time restrictions. For the purpose of this example, I'll be showing or displaying this assignment a day before and display until the due date. Click Submit. Let us now click the assignment itself and see how you will view the student submissions, if there is any. This is the instructor's view, the assignment inbox. And in here, you can see the name of your students, their submissions, date that it was submitted, and then the similarity report score. The instructor must always visit and review the similarity report settings found in this cog icon here. Select similarity settings. Always remember that every time you create an assignment that will be run through Turnitin, the default setting is that submissions are going to be saved in the submitted works repository. So always identify the index to submitted works, whether to turn on or off. Turning this on means that you are allowing to have the student submission saved in the submitted works repository, and turning it off means you are not saving it here. I recommend to have works like theses to not be saved in here, especially if it will be uploaded again for thesis 2 or another need for similarity report, because the second upload will provide 100% similarity score. But if these are just essays or works that may need the similarity report, then have this turned on. Next in the setting is for you to decide the searched repositories. Leave this as is so that submitted works will be checked against a bigger collection. For now, let us leave the exclude from similarity report and select the recommended generation of similarity reports. Let us also leave the student access as is. And for the student resubmission, this is to whether you want to have your students submit a number of submissions or just one. Let us turn this on, allowing students to have unlimited resubmissions. Then save the settings if there are changes. And let's close this tab. Let us now enter the student's preview mode. For instructors, this is usually being done so as to check whether our activity settings are working well. For Turnitin Originality, this is very useful for faculty researchers to check their own research works for similarity. Now, do not worry, as your student won't be able to see your work or their classmates. Only their submissions are viewable on their end. Now let us click the assignment as a student and try uploading a document. Now the document that I will be uploading is a file that has already been saved in the submitted works repository and should have a 100% similarity score. For initial submissions, a student shall encounter an agreement to the use of Turnitin, and once agreed upon, the student can now submit documents. Before doing so, the student can see the due date of the assignment as well as the instructions for it. Now I will click the A Touch from My Computer button and select a file. Now the student needs to review the file to be submitted and click Submit. The student will instantly see the similarity report score and may decide to either resubmit another file. The student can also see other details like the submission history, the digital receipt, or download the original paper. Now for this example, let's try resubmitting another file. And as you can see, a message will appear that the resubmissions will be overwritten and it will generate a new similarity report. So just click on continue. Look for the file, click upload, review, and click submit. Now that is two resubmissions made for this assignment. Let us try resubmitting another paper for this action. And upon doing so, again, the student should need to review and finally click on the submit button. Let us try clicking the similarity score for this paper, which has 100% similarity. And upon seeing this score, of course, the student can modify the paper as to where to put proper citations and the like. Clicking on the settings, let us try to exclude search repositories in the similarity report. Say, for example, the internet, publications, crossref. And once the student does that, of course, the settings will not be saved because only the instructor can do that. So even if the similarity score decreases at the student's end, the instructor can still see the actual and initial similarity report score. So let's try closing these tabs. Exit student preview and go back to the instructor's view. Let us click on the assignment and check the inbox for the submitted work on student preview. You can see here that the student has submitted thrice. The latest document uploaded has a 100% similarity score. And the ellipsis here identifies the originality ID or paper ID. Let's see the similarity report by clicking on this score. Now, here is the source overview, which identified a submitted work in the Mapua University submitted works. You cannot see the document in the submitted works as it is private. Intellectual property comes in, thus one cannot view the document. Let's select all sources. To see the different repositories that this paper has a match with. So this is where the instructor's assessment or analysis comes in. One should not be reliant to the similarity score, but be able to see the similar lines or words in the documents. Now, say, for example, this one. This came from the Ateneo de Manila University Library, and are common facts or common words. So the assessment or an assessment of the instructor may be to have that excluded in the similarity score. So this also goes the same to the lines, which has a proper citation, as well as in the references, highlighted references or bibliographies in the paper. So let's click the cog icon and update the settings or update the exclude from similarity report. As you can see, it has 24 similar sources. And if we are to exclude bibliography, if we are to exclude quotes, citations, small matches with less than 20 words, automatically the score from the similar sources has been narrowed down. Now, this is going to be viewed as well in the instructor's assignment inbox, as well as in the student's view. Now, the similarity report also has a flag icon here, identifying what the student may have done in the document. Like for this one, it's a hidden text. So clicking on these hidden text flag, you can see the highlighted lines or words in the paper. Now, this is trying to alter the plagiarism tool's algorithm. So a document may also be flagged if there are replaced text, like using a different font style or replacing letters to interrupt the similarity match. But the flags do not necessarily mean that there's a problem. So for instance, in this file uploaded, I had a text copy-pasted from a chat box. So this is where an instructor's assessment and analysis, the review of the paper of the student submission comes in. Also, under document details, the instructor can be able to identify information of the paper author, laptops or software owner and the like. You may be able to identify if there are student collusion, if there is modification made and that owners differ from author and the last modified by. Just like the student's view, the instructor can print the digital receipt of the similarity report by clicking on this printer icon here. And lastly, clicking on the question mark button here identifies the guides, tours, and the display paper ID. Now let's go back to the course and check how feedback and grading is done. Going into the full grade center, look for the assignment. and let us select the student preview submission. Clicking on View Grade Details. And you may now be able to input the grades as well as the feedback to the learner. And click Save. Now that is how you create an assignment, provide feedback, input grades, and upload documents for faculty researcher inside Turnitin Originality in Blackboard. If you have questions and clarifications, contact yours truly via email at kosoria@mapua.edu.ph. You can also get in touch with Ms. Arlene Alonso, our Turnitin administrator, at aaalonso@mapua.edu.ph. Thank you and have a good day.